Well, the roads are empty, but speeds are high as drivers are putting the pedal to the metal during the pandemic. As 13 Chief Investigator Darcy Spears shows you, police are now on the prowl and some drivers are crying foul.
What is Metro Police going to do when there's a world emergency going on? Having a speed trap.
Police see this as saving lives, preserving ambulances and hospital resources for coronavirus victims. Dave Brecken looks at it differently.
I saw it as bullying.
Brecken took these cell phone videos on March 31st along I-15 North near St. Rose Parkway.
They were giving out ticket after ticket after ticket. You know, and it was just, they were just chicken hawking people.
Metro did give out ticket after ticket after ticket that afternoon.
That day we were out there, we made 81 stops. We wrote 89 infractions.
All in just a 3-hour period.
Does it kind of make your officers wonder, who are all you people? Why are you out here? Where are you going?
Well, you know what, especially when we've been asked to stay home.
Metro Traffic Lieutenant Brett Ficklin says the area around St. Rose and the 15 has been a car crash hotspot, which is why it was targeted for enforcement.
Of the 28 fatalities we've had this year, 8 have occurred in that area command.
In the few days after that interview, 2 more people died in car crashes, bringing Metro's year-to-date fatality total to 30.
To kind of put that in perspective, we've had 19 murders. So we've had more people killed on the roadways.
Ficklin says focused actions like this one are not set up to trap people, but to enforce the marked speed limit.
And we stopped 6 vehicles that were doing triple digit speeds. And the top speed that day was 121 miles an hour. That area out there is marked 65 miles an hour.
The Nevada Office of Traffic Safety reports a 47% decrease in deaths this March compared to last year. Officials believe that was largely due to the decrease in traffic volumes across the state, prompting Dave Brecken to ask,
why now? Why now at a time like this are they giving tickets? There's other things they can do, you know, but I just think the timing's bad.
Metro says the timing is just right.
Pandemic speeders is a term that people are starting to use. Are you seeing motorists take advantage of less traffic to go too fast?
Yes.
He says because roads are more open, people feel more free to open up on the interstate and on side streets.
We've had 6 fatals occur, fatal collisions occur since the shutdown. Of those 6, 4 were excessive speed related. And so we're taking all these extraordinary measures, but people don't see a problem with jumping in their car and speeding down the roadway, which not only endangers them, but endangers the others on the roadway as well.
They see it as doing part of their job, but they haven't taken a look at the human side of it, where people are sick, people have fear, people don't have money, and now they have this to worry about.
From the person who's receiving the citation or a person from the outside looking in, it may seem heartless.
Ficklin says they're not writing citations because they've got nothing better to do or because higher-ups are telling officers to increase their ticket tally.
A lot of people think that, oh, it's the end of the month, you guys need to write more tickets for pay or whatever. We get absolutely no revenue from the tickets we write.
Courts set traffic costs and the money goes to fund the court system, which is currently on hold.
At the current moment, there's no traffic court going on, so obviously all of this is going to be pushed back anyways.
Also, last week, in an effort to limit coronavirus spread, Las Vegas Justice Court suspended enforcement of about 270,000 traffic cases in warrant status until 60 days after the governor's stay-at-home directive is lifted. That means anyone who has a traffic warrant won't be held accountable at this time. Still, Brecken thinks traffic stops should be handled differently.
You know, if you want to slow traffic coming into Las Vegas, do what Nevada Highway Patrol does.
He's talking about staging an unoccupied car as a deterrent or using freeway signs to warn people to slow down.
At a time like this, when so many people are out of work and don't have incomes, has there been any discussion about issuing warnings instead of expensive tickets, or is that not effective?
Metro says warnings are forgettable. Tickets are not.
If I issue a citation, I can guarantee that you're going to have to think about it at least 3 more times, because you're thinking about it at the time that I give it to you, you're thinking about it at the time that you have to go to court for it, and you're thinking about it at the time you have to pay the penalty.
Brecken says there's something else to consider during the coronavirus pandemic.
So they have an officer that pulls over a car. They have contact with the car. with the occupants of that car. What if that car has COVID-19 positive person in it?
That's how Nevada Highway Patrol is looking at things right now. This month was NHP's turn to lead Southern Nevada's targeted enforcement, but the agency canceled the operation due to COVID-19. NHP says it's still enforcing traffic laws, but limiting their exposure to motorists and not performing traffic safety task force operations until further notice. As for Metro,
we do have a concern about the contact that we have to have with the public.
As of April 21st, 14 Metro employees had tested positive for COVID-19, with 9 test results still pending.
Metro's website doesn't detail how those employees contracted the virus.
There's nothing that any of us motor officers would love more than to be able to cruise around the valley, have an officer presence, and enjoy riding in the weather, and not have to make contact with people. But we can't stop policing.
And Metro has seen another rising crime during the pandemic, street racing, which has led to increased complaints from residents in areas like Hollywood and Washington, the West End of Alta, and on the Strip.
We had a truck and a Mustang going over 100 miles an hour northbound on Las Vegas Boulevard, right by the Welcome to Las Vegas sign. So there's no place in the valley that's impervious to what's going on with the speeds right now.
Though hitting drivers in the wallet might not sit well right now, Metro and NHP say their only goal is to keep our roads as safe as possible. And they emphasize that no one should expect a free pass due to the pandemic. Their message, slow down and arrive alive. Darcy Spears, 13 Investigates.